Everybody clap your hands.
Motivation.
Three things that are in for the new year. First is letting go of self-doubt. If you have a project that you've been wanting to start or a dream job or even just posting content, this is your sign to do it. Throw the doubt out the window and get it going, girl. Get it going, okay? Second is releasing what doesn't align with you. Moving the clutter only makes space for things that are worth your time. Not everyone and everything is going to make it to the next chapter, so if something is not sitting right with you, let it go. The minute you start doing this, more things will come in for you. Listen, this is varsity. Some people have to stay in JV, okay? Third is being your authentic self. Don't try to fit a mold or be small for other people to like you. The right people will stick around and the other people can exit stage left. You're not for everyone and that's a good thing. So be yourself because you're a vibe. And if anyone hasn't told you today, I am proud of you and you deserve to have the best year. So go after the things that you want and do not let any doubt stop you.
We got that.
Try being my size, Amy. You don't know how it is.
A good man, Savannah. A good man.
Wow. I actually admire hearing that.
Mmm. I just love the taste of nothing.
I'm not laughing. I'm not.
Something not that chill happened last night.
It's one thing to, like, your friends, like, meet your other friends and they become friends and, like, they really hit it off. Good for them. No, really, I'm so happy for you guys. Weirdo. Anyways, Alyssa, when she has to share. Okay. It's one thing to do that. That horrible thing, but it's an I'm just kidding, okay? I'm just kidding, I'm being dramatic. But it's another thing for them to, like, learn about all of their friends. Like, what are, now you're chasing clout. Like, before, like, you were on the bridge of chasing clout. Like, now you're literally chasing it. Like, you're chasing it so fast, like, you're sweaty everywhere. Like, I can smell you through the screen. Like, that's how much you're chasing it. Like, what are you doing commenting on their cousin's Instagram? You're weird!
You know what it never was? That's serious. It was never that serious.
You was hungry, so I'm busting.
Fuck you!
Yeah, I swear to God, I'm so player.
Three opposite dynamics that every best friend duo has. These are just facts, I don't make the rules. First is who you find attractive. Me and my best friend will have the most opposite taste in men. She'll show me a photo and I'll be like, cute. Also, why is there always one friend that's super boy crazy and the other one does not want a man in a 10-mile radius? Two is how you dress. You cannot be best friends if you don't have an opposite aesthetic. Like, your style could be completely different, but somehow cohesive. Last is the introvert-extrovert dynamic. You always have the one friend who's super adventurous, life of the party, and the other one is waiting in the corner to call the Uber home. Thank you.
We're going to go ahead and pick up with question six. Now, who here thinks they know the answer to question six? Tucker! The answer, right, the answer to question six. You know, I'm going to put it in my notebook here.
You're confused. I'm fucking confused, bro.
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from?
Fuck you! Fuck you, motherfucker!
There are three types of friends we all have. First is the friend who has the same exact humor as you. Like, everything you guys say, comedy gold. Best part is no one else will understand or find whatever you guys are saying funny. Everyone will just be like, I don't get it. Second is the older sister friend. They don't actually have to be older, but they are the wisest one of the group. This is the friend that gives the absolute best advice. If you're stressed or you need to talk something out, they got you. These friends are basically like our free therapists. Last is the bad decision friend. Listen, someone's got to keep it spicy. This is the friend that if you go out with them, you might need an ambulance on speed dial. This friend will always guarantee you a good time. Like, there is never a dull moment. Like, you already know there's just always going to be chaos. So, side note, why does the wildest friend always have the strictest parent? Like, without fail, these are just facts.
Let it go. Oh, baby, I don't wanna know.
I think I'll do a wrap around. Wrap around. I think I'll do a wrap around. Wrap around.
Walk, walk, walk. Woohoo! Smaller steps. Wow! 1, 2, 3. Woohoo!
I want to talk to you about my Margaret moment, the first time I got my period. I was a super late bloomer. I'm talking 16 years old late.
16? Oh my god.
I was the last person in my friend group to get my period, which kind of felt like the last person on earth to get my period. It felt like everybody was in this cool kid club except me, and I just remember feeling so left out. While everyone was discussing their changing bodies and buying bras, I was over here flat-chested and brace-faced. The day I got my period, I thought I was sick because my stomach, whoo, it was in pain. I went to the bathroom with my best friend and boom, I got it. I thought it was gonna look like the Niagara Falls, but it was just a little spotting. Also, I had no idea how to wear a pad, so I had to have her come help me. The rest of the day, I did not stop talking about it. I acted like I won an Oscar, and I have to tell everybody. For more awkward moments about puberty, growing up, and what it means to be a woman, make sure to check out Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret, only in theaters, April 28th.
Are you ready? Girl. Why every single time you get dressed, you're showing like half your body? Because I can? Are you ready or no? Yeah, I don't know, like, do you not have any shirts? Like, you're always showing skin. I don't have nothing. Well, I don't have nothing else to wear. All my shirts are like, they're cropped off. Whoa, you don't have like a jacket or something? Like, simple. No, it's okay. It's okay. It's a method. It's okay. Let's go. We're leaving. You're really gonna go like that? We'll see. I don't know. I have nothing else to wear.
Hi.
Hi.
Are you pro-choice or pro-life?
Why don't you have a boyfriend?
What's the point? When I like them, they don't like me. When they like me, I don't like them.
God damn it! Gosh darn it! Shit! Shoot!
I want you and I want us.
But then act like it. I'm sick of words.
Everybody know them Oakland hoes is red flags. Y'all be thinking that I'm joking, but I'm dead ass. MMB.
Girly things your mom should tell you, hairstyle edition. Alright, I just got a haircut, but my hair was longer, but today we're doing hairstyles for long hair. Up first, this is a crowd favorite, the claw clip. I like this one because it keeps your hair out of your face, and it doesn't mess or put any dents in your hair when you, like, style it. Make sure you pull out these little hairs so it looks extra cute.
Up next, a cute set of double braids. The key to the operation are these little rubber bands. Put your braid is in, pull it apart a bit to give the illusion of super thick, awesome hair. Next is half updo. The key to this is brushing out your part right in the middle. And this is awesome because it kind of keeps your hair out of your way, but also shows off its length. And you're going to want to use little ponytails again for this one.
Psychological ways to get people to like you, part 1. When you're talking to someone, always show the palms of your hands. This communicates to their subconscious mind that you have nothing to hide, that you are open, that they can trust you, and you are their friend.
Hey, yo, chill! Speak up when I hop by the car, I promise I'ma speak up when I hop by the cut, I promise I'ma speak up when I hop about the cut, I promise I'm gonna make a scene, got lights, can't.
I've been doing my homework and I want to talk to you about something.
Do you think your eyes are a little too smoky for every day?
Yeah, I'm going through a phase. Is that okay with you?
Sure.
Okay.